Ghana has dropped from the top of the continent to third in respect for media freedom within the last 2 years. Now, the Ghana Journalists Association, GJA, says the lack of stringent punitive measures for perpetrators of crimes against journalists emboldens others to engage in similar crimes.
For exercising their fundamental rights, journalists and media workers are assaulted, intimidated, prosecuted and subjected to all manner of harassment. Some are even killed and their families threatened. In 2018 alone, 94 journalists and media staff were killed in work-related incidents, as reported by the International Federation of Journalists. Hundreds more have been subjected to arbitrary arrest or detention without ever having been tried. Regrettably, governments across the world fail to protect journalists and prosecute perpetrators of crimes against media workers.
The GJA will maintain an obsessive focus on the safety of journalists and demand that politicians in their prowl for votes strictly keep their hands off journalists. We also seize the opportunity to caution journalists to sharpen their sense of safety and security in order not to fall easy prey to enemies of press freedom and freedom of expression.
Press freedom ranking of 2017 puts Ghana on top of the continent with respect to press freedom. However, that is no longer the case. The Media Foundation for West Africa has recorded about 35 violations against journalists and media houses since then. 12 violations have been recorded in the year 2019, placing the country third behind Nigeria and Guinea in the past 2 years.
No matter the words that we use in expressing our disagreement, that is not cause for somebody to take a stick and hit somebody in the neck. Because when people are able to freely express their thought, no matter how vicious their thought, it takes away a certain venom.
As these crimes multiply, journalists impose self-censorship, leading to a climate of fear and anxiety.
And I think that from a position of being the first in Africa and then recording incidents that is far above the West African average, we must be concerned and we must take measures to end impunity for crimes against journalists.
The event attracted comments from the British High Commission, Ghana Independent Broadcasters Association, UNESCO, and some senior journalists.
Journalists represent the voices of the voiceless, especially those that are vulnerable. And it is important that we continue to support their work.
The life of a journalist is as precious as that of any other person. GIBA is proud to be part of today's clarion call as we add our voice to the many others who have called for the need to implement definite measures in countering the culture of impunity, which seems to be on the ascendancy and is threatening our moral fiber as a society.